Alright. I'm here to show you what the fuck I've been doing with myself, and not making beer videos. For one thing, Chris is extremely busy. He's been working a variety of jobs, and has 5 kids to look after. He and his wife, and the wife has a home-based business, so things are busy at Chris's house, and so we haven't been making really any videos, because we ain't got no time. I got a new job back in September, and really, our schedules aren't meshing up, so for now, the beer videos are on hold, and I thought I might give you something that I've been doing with myself, and some clanmates of mine playing World of Tanks. You'll see on our left the M103, slightly retarded. You can see him fire into the ground as we go by. No particular reason, he's just that dumb. I see people do that all the time, and it usually means you're gonna lose, because people are so dumb they can't keep shells in their tank and shoot enemies with them. It's a problem. Now, what we're doing here is what we like to call Team 300. You have, there are a couple of things in the game based on the E-100 chassis. There is the E-100, as you see in front of me. There is the Jagdpanzer E-100 that I am driving, which is the tank destroyer model. And then there's the GW Type E, or Gunwagen Type E, which is the German top-tier artillery. Now, this is some big boy shit here. You don't mess around with tier 10s like you do in anything else. They're expensive to run, you want to win, you want to do well. You'll notice that Tiger Mate is slightly underdressed for the occasion. We eventually... Oh, and then he scratches my paint because he's a jealous, jealous man. However, he not paying attention gets shot in the back of the head. We will make allowances for that because he's much better at tanks than I am. Now, our main objective here is to hold this corner. If you can see down on the mini-map to the right-hand side, if they get past us, they're in our base, and then we get Ponzoored, because they can get on our capture point, and they can capture our base. We don't want that to happen. What we do want to have happen, with English in my face and mouth, is death and destruction. Now I'm just holding here, and a bounce off. That was actually a dumb thing for me to do. I should not have taken that shot. So, I have a 21-second reload time, and I pull back, and I'm angling here. So if anybody shoots up past my friends here, all they're going to do is hit the very corner of my tank. And they're going to bounce off, and then they're going to feel a world of pain. Now I'm zooming back in, loaded up. Boom! 1,200, almost 1,300 damage. That was one of the highest rolls possible, and since that happened, Erator steals my kill. And then we just kind of go back, and we can hold. And it's the right move to do. We are down a couple of tanks. All of our bad chats seem to have not performed up to their potential. Everybody has a bad game though, so you never know. And I'm trying to get him. Trying to get him bounced off. That's not a quality enterprise. Erator bounced off. And it's at this point I seem to notice that perhaps all is not going quite the way we would. Oh, maybe we're gonna go down? Maybe not? No? Okay. Oh, hey, you know. Oh, owned. Artillery in the face. Hey, wait, what's going on back here? We're being invaded. Goddamn Mongolians. Now, you'll notice that everybody over there has less than 1,300 hit points. I can one-shot every one of those suckers. The top damage roll on my gun is like 1,300 hit points, which doesn't happen all the time. Rarely, if ever. I tried to lead the target there, that didn't work. Occasionally you get away with blind shots, but it's not often the case. We're trying to lead the bad shad, I don't have a turret, so I keep having to adjust my aim and then wait for the aim time. And I'm not loaded, I'm just trying to set myself up for a shot. Now I am loaded. And that sucker is just sitting there, waiting to get fucked. And then we move on with our life. Bad shot over there is dead. T-57 heavy over here. Oh, I'm still getting used to this. I'm very sorry. He's now dead because Erator stole my kill. Again. Jeez. We have a WZ-131, which I think is a medium tank. Maybe it's a light tank. I don't really know. Either way, he's tracked right in front of me and now dead. they've got that AMX 1375 way out there on that island. That's a bad place to be unless you're winning. And hey, look, there's a Panther 2 right in front of my face. And he bounced off me, and Air Tour stole my kill again. What the fuck? Seriously, dude? Jeez. Anyway, don't even like the guy that much. I mean, he's awesome. He's great. Saved my life, I swear. Come on, WZ. Come on. Come on. Oh, nobody wants to play with me. So there's just the three of us left. And you'll notice that Airtor has three of my kills. Tigermate's got one and I've got two. What that means is we're pretty close to Brothers in Arms, which is an award you get if all people on your squad get, ow, my periscope, you fuck. If everybody on your team gets three kills, or if everybody in your platoon gets three kills, which is easier to do with only a two-man platoon than a three, then you get Brothers in Arms. And there's my third. So I got three, Airtor's got three, Tigermate's got two. Which means he needs one, and then we get Brothers in Arms on Team 300, which is pretty awesome. That being said, there's only one guy left on the other team, and he's got options. He can run, he can hide, he can suicide if he wants. He can drive out into the water and drown. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and track him down. I've thought about just making you watch the entire slow-mo chase in agonizing slowness with the slow. And you'll notice that the M12 was bitching and complaining in the thing about nothing specific. He's just, you know, an angry artillery player. They get killed a lot. Look, what's he saying? GT more kills than you, so I'm better. I don't know if that means he got more kills so he's better, or he got more kills so he's bitter. If you don't speak English, don't try and type in English. Well, I mean, that's not fair. If you can try, but don't expect us to care. Which actually leads me to another thing. If you ever play World of Tanks, make sure you type things in a different language into chat just to troll Americans, because apparently Americans don't know that North America also includes Mexico, and that Canada has two languages, one of which is French. So if you can speak Spanish or French, or actually if you can speak a different language than that, it's a good idea to troll Americans, because it's hilarious. America! North America, we speak English! And it's great. A lot of fun. So we're trying to get Tigermate his third kill here. You can see he's back there. We're up here. Airtor and I are the sheepdogs in this situation. And I could have easily just popped the crap out of him, and that would have been it. But I don't do that, because that would be... that would be nicht bueno, as we like to say. So at this point, we're trying to figure out what's the what the best thing in life is, which is to drive GW Panthers before you and hear the lamentations of their women. So I told Tigermate, just cut right back down the middle. I'll go the long way around. And Airtor, stop stealing my kills. Well, at this point, actually, I think it's just the T-44, but it could be a couple people start bitching and complaining that we're not capturing the base, and blah, blah, blah. And I believe it's pretty quickly here that I try and tell them we're trying to get Brothers in Arms. It's a thing we would like. To which people can or cannot respond favorably. Don't really care, they're all dead, there's nothing they can do. But, yeah, I actually did toy with the idea of speeding this up, but I figured, you know, why not drag it out? Why not make you go through all of the pain and agony that we did? Actually, we were pretty giddy at this point. We were laughing, and, as you can see there, trying to get Brothers in Arms. If you can't do the math, if you don't know what's going on, that's what's up. And the T-44 does not know what's up. Airtor, ever the showman and diplomat seeks to placate the masses. Oh yes, I will go affirmative, I will go cap, yes. But really, we had no real intention of doing that. We're gonna sheepdog that fucker till he either drowns himself or Tiger Maid gets his kill. And, we're closing in on it. We're closing in. Time? T-44 wants to know about time? Well, there's more than 5 minutes left. So, don't get your titties in a twist. It's not a big deal. We can put the afterburners on if we want. We just don't tell people about that. You can see I'm getting all the way up to 33, sometimes 34 on a downhill slope. I am a god. And it looks like we chased the GW Panther right back to his original hiding spot behind a rock. And as you can see, Tiger Maid's going for the kill. Boom. End of story. Brothers in Arms, Team 300, we rule planets. Entire galaxies sometimes. That's been your introduction to me on World of Tanks. Hope you liked it. If you don't, there's lots of other people doing it, so go watch them. Peace.